In this video, I'm going to talk about thyroid swelling that is moving upwards and downwards with deglutition. This is one of the common clinical questions they will ask you in your thyroid case. Okay, let us see some anatomy about the thyroid gland. First, this swelling is the thyroid gland. Okay, so what you are seeing is a anterior posterior view. This is the anterior, this is the posterior. Okay, see, the thyroid gland is enclosed by the capsule, that is investing layer of deep cervical fascia, and both aspects like anteriorly and posteriorly. Okay, it completely encloses the thyroid gland. But in the posterior aspect, it condenses to form a ligament called Berry's ligament. Okay, posterior medially, it condenses to form a ligament called Berry's ligament. So this ligament has got an attachment to the cricoid cartilage as well as to the larynx. Okay, you just imagine, as we all know, that the larynx will move upward and downward with the deglutation. So if the on deglutation, what will happen? The larynx will move upwards. Since the larynx is moving upwards, this ligament as like a pulley, this also moves upwards. The thyroid, as a whole thyroid gland, is also moving upward. Similarly, on downward movement, it is moving downwards. Okay, so this is the reason why the thyroid gland is moving upwards and downwards with deglutation. It's very simple. Thyroid gland is enclosed anteriorly and posteriorly by the investing layer of deep cervical fascia. Posterior medially, it condenses to form a ligament called Berry's ligament, which has got an attachment to the cricoid cartilage and as well as to the larynx. On deglutation, the larynx move upwards. As a whole, the thyroid gland is also moving upwards. What are the other swelling that moves up and down with deglutation apart from thyroid swelling? Number one, it is nothing but pre-tracheal and pre-laryngeal lymph node. Okay, the lymph nodes that are present within the pretracheal fascia are they also move up and down with deglutation. And number two is subhyoid bursitis. So this is one condition just below the hyoid bone, the bursa is there, so that will produce a swelling that is also enclosed within the pretracheal fascia. And number three is the thyroglossal cyst. Thyroglossal cyst is also one of the swelling that is present within the pretracheal fascia. And number four is any swelling that arising from the trachea or larynx that also move up and down with deglutation. Okay, so these are the swelling that moves up and down with the deglutation. Even in thyroid swelling, there are certain conditions there won't be any movement with deglutation. This is also another question they will ask you. Even if it is a thyroid gland swelling, but there is no movement with deglutation. Here, the number one is the carcinoma of the thyroid gland. So what will happen? Because of the carcinoma of the thyroid, there will be local infiltration. So local infiltration, because of that, there is movement is not there. And number two is the thyroiditis, Riddle's thyroiditis. Here also, as like malignancy, here also because of the inflammation, it will be adherent to the localized, that is nearby structures, thyroiditis. And number three is a big goiter. Because of the large size,
there is no space to move up and down at all. That is the number 3. And number 4 is the retrosternal goiter with intrathoracic impaction. Intrathoracic impaction. There are a lot of types of there in retrosternal goiter, but only in the retrosternal goiter with intrathoracic impaction only the swelling, there won't be any movement at all.